Millions of us were lucky enough to see the 2024 Great North American Eclipse, and it truly was North American, having started out in the west in Mexico, working its way up across the United States and then into Canada along the Great Lakes region, and finally exiting in Newfoundland and even being seen, at least in partial form, in parts of Greenland. Unfortunately, there was one large cloud bank that messed things up in parts of Mexico and the southern United States, and another cloud bank that conveniently set itself up to mess things up in the Niagara-Toronto region. Too bad, because of the large population who'd gone to that area to see it. This magnificent video was put together by the European Space Agency, and you can certainly see the shadow of the moon crisscrossing North America, again from Mexico all the way up to the eastern parts of Canada and the US. NASA and the International Space Station provided another amazing view of the moon's shadow, in this case from a much closer vantage point, but nothing like the way the rest of us could see it, with the moon actually blocking out the sun, and we really had the best view of all. Like many of you, I spent the time leading up to totality either watching through eclipse glasses or through a pinhole viewer, and as interesting as that was, it really pales in comparison to totality itself. And, well, here's what we saw. It's hard to describe how much darker it is the moment totality begins, and yet, at the same time, how bright the corona still looks, even though it's actually way dimmer than the surface of the sun, which is normally why we can't see it during daytime. Now, in all the excitement, did you notice some slightly pinkish blobs, particularly at the bottom of the sun? Well, at least from my viewing location, that's actually what I was really hoping to see, and by stopping down the camera's iris and reducing the brightness, well, here they are, the solar prominences. They're arc-shaped filaments of charged plasma particles following looping magnetic fields on the sun's surface. Don't let the seemingly small size deceive you. The biggest one we saw is about 4 or 5 times the diameter of the Earth in height. It's really quite unimaginable. And you can see the loops of particles best at the lower one, the bright one that most people saw. It's almost like there was a horseshoe magnet below the sun's surface. Of course there isn't, but instead the fields are created by the flow of the charged particles in unimaginably complex ways. NASA has some slightly better cameras than I do, and in 2015 the Solar Dynamics Observatory, a science satellite, took some amazing 6-hour time-lapse video showing what happens in those types of prominences. Look at the fine filaments of charged particles following the magnetic fields, and look what happens when the magnetic loop somehow breaks and expels a sea of charged particles out into space, a solar flare, and hopefully those particles don't head in our direction, which, in a worst case scenario, if they did hit Earth, can disrupt communications and power grids, something that we really haven't experienced in this modern high-tech age and would probably be quite disastrous. So, with this video coming to an end, did you see the eclipse? And was it either partial or total and clear or cloudy skies? It'd be amazing to hear experiences from all across the continent, so please tell us what you saw in the comments section. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video and see you next time.